Good morning, caregivers. Welcome to Tuesday morning. Yeah. And this is Let's Talk Dementia live on Facebook. And I am so glad that you are tuned in here today. We're going to talk about dementia, dementia caregiving, and getting out of the house. Oh, yeah, that's good for us. A special thank you to our sponsors, HD Imports, located on Flint Street Extension in Rock Hill, South Carolina. They are the mechanics that you want. They are amazing mechanics at Hyundais, Acuras, Toyotas, and Kias. Yeah, it just doesn't come out all and just bang, bang, bang off my lips, does it? You can reach them at 803-985-0985 and tell them Carol sent you. And also, Beth Crosby, Editor Beth. And you can find her at editorbeth.com. If you have written something or you have a website or a blog, she needs to be looking at it and make sure that you are representing yourself in the best way possible. So contact her at editorbeth.com. And also, Life in the Carolinas, the amazing award-winning Emmy-nominated television show about life in North and South Carolina. And you can find them at lifeinthecarolinas.com as well as on YouTube. So we are thankful for all three of these wonderful companies and individuals who support our ministry by advertising on this show. If you are interested in us advertising for you, then just write me, Carol at letstalkdementia.org. We can talk about this show as well as our podcast. And if you've not listened to our podcast, it's a good thing to have on when you're in your car. You can go to iTunes and subscribe to Let's Talk Dementia. You can find us on Spotify. And soon, I hope, we're going to be on iHeartRadio. But Let's Talk Dementia. I don't know how many hundreds of episodes there are there for you. And you can join the people who live in 75 different countries who are listening to us. It's pretty cool. Wanted to remind you of our new book, Reminisce and Worship. That's my mama's hands. I love that picture. Oh, makes me so happy. And this is an easy to read, colorful devotional written for that person who has dementia. They can look at the picture, read the scripture, and have the questions that go right along with it. And it gives you something to work with them, or they can do this all on their own. You can find it on Amazon. So thank you for checking that out. Well, today I wanted to talk about getting out of the house. Now, you know it's good for you to get out of the house every once in a while. You need to experience the sunshine and see the grass and the trees and all that good stuff. It's just good for you. But it's also good for your LO, your loved one. But you got to do a little planning before you go. So I just want to tell you a recent story, recent as in yesterday afternoon. So Mr. Howell, my sweet husband, flew out really early Monday morning. Like, we were up at 4 a.m. to get him to the airport. Who plans flights for 6 o'clock in the morning? I mean, but anyway, Allegiant Airline does, that's who. And we're an hour away, so we had to get him there. So he flew in to get his brother and my husband's car, to drive the car and my brother-in-law to Florida, because my brother-in-law will be living here also. Had it all planned. It's going to go like this. Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. My brother-in-law is going to pick him. Other brother-in-law is going to pick him up at the airport. Help him load up the few things that still need to go in the car. In the car, they would go on the trip to Florida halfway on Monday. The rest of the way on Tuesday. Ernie moved to assisted living around 2 or 3 today. That was the plan. Was. It ain't. No more. Because y'all know how life goes. So everything was just flying along. Man, they got in the car about an hour and a half earlier than he ever anticipated they would. Life was good. They're tooling down the road. They get somewhere in Florida. Who knows where they were. And the car dies. The car just dies. Not good. Well, the battery had died in the car. That's what happened. And, you're alongside the interstate. Well, he'd gotten off the interstate and he was alongside a pretty major highway, about a 6-lane road, and trucks are shoo, 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 by 90,000 miles an hour. And my brother-in-law getting a little bit freaky. Well, now Ernie has PTSD from having been in Vietnam and has issues, a lot of issues because of that. And then Michael's dealing with a car that's not running. And there's people driving by a million miles an hour. And he's calling me, and his car and his battery on his phone was getting low. And he's not quite sure where he is for me to be able to call and get help. And one problem after the other. But in God's goodness and his love of and care for us, I was able to find a tow truck that was there with to help him in about 20-25 minutes, and took him to the hotel and took him to right next door to a Waffle House so they could get something to eat. And the car is at a wonderful mechanic this morning, hopefully gonna get that battery fixed, but they're not gonna be able to get to it until this afternoon. So here is another day of spending the night in a hotel, and maybe tomorrow getting into our town and getting Ernie moved. That's just life. It's just the way it goes. You have to plan ahead, though. So fortunately, Michael had thought, okay, I probably should keep a little extra cash because I'm going to be on the road. Not everybody takes credit card, y'all. I know that's a surprise to you. So a little extra cash, that's something you want to think about when you're out with your loved one. The last thing you want is to be out and not have cash if you need it. Now, I know that we seem to be a cashless society, but if you get in parts of town that if the internet's down and you need to use your credit card and they can't take it, you sunk, girlfriend. So make sure you have some cash on you. Well, if you are traveling for really about any distance at all, like from your house to Walmart, you might want to consider having a couple snacks in your car if you're traveling with someone with any kind of physical and or cognitive issues. If they don't have cognitive issues and they just have physical issues, but you were to get stuck for some reason, your car were to die, you were to have some kind of issue and you couldn't, you know, move about, you might wish you had something to snack on. And our folks who have cognitive issues, when they get hungry, they get hangry, don't they? Oh yeah, they do. The hungry turns into being angry, and we're hangry. And you know, if your car's broke down on the side of the road, that's the last thing you need is somebody being hangry with you. So you throw them some Doritos or some, Michael's been wanting some Cheetos, so maybe some Cheetos. You know, not that I'm for that kind of food, but you do need to keep something in your car that is not going to turn green and fuzzy, that in an emergency you can have for food for your loved one that has cognitive issues if you were to get stuck in your car. Now, another thing you want to have in your car, is for that other end, maybe it depends, and a package of wipes, you know, like baby wipes. Because I'm telling you, these things happen, and if you don't believe they happen, I'll give you Michael's phone number, and he can tell you what he's going through pretty easily, and it's not been a lot of fun for him. I want to show you a little creature that I think you ought to have in your car. My friend Beth, editor Beth, just wrote, Cheetos won't go bad. They're bad enough to start with. That's the gospel truth. There is a restaurant, I think it's Kentucky Fried Chicken. I don't know who it is that's doing Cheeto-covered chicken or something that's... Yeah, Cheetos, I think they're covering Cheetos in, or covering chicken in Cheetos. I mean, they are out to kill us, but we're talking about emergency food here. Okay, this little gadget, anybody know what this is? This is pretty neat, that's what it is. This is called a car cane. Car cane, C-A-N-E. And you can get it on Amazon. This particular one is made, it's called the original Emson, E-M-S-O-N, car cane, C-A-N-E. If you just Google car cane, there's a bunch of them. And it's like $12. They used to be $20. When I bought this one, it was $20. Now they're like $12. But what is it? It is the neatest thing if you are traveling with anybody who has a hard time getting in and out of the car, in or out. All right, so you're in your car, you open the door. I'm facing the front of the car. I wish I could, if I could have gotten in my car and shown you this and hold the camera all at the same time, it would have been good, but I don't have four arms, in case you hadn't noticed. It's just two. So you're facing the front of your car, and you open your door out, right? Well, back here on the frame of your door is a little U-shaped metal piece. I don't know. I guess maybe it's part of the locking mechanism. I don't know what it is. But this end fits down in that U-shaped metal piece. And this is sticking into the open area of where your door used to be, so that when you turn around to get out, you can put your hand down on that and use it to help push yourself up. Now, I use this with my mama so many times because it made her safer. She could push down and raise up out of that seat to get out of the car. Now, when she was getting in the car, she was always with her walker, and I was always careful that when I took the walker away for her to be able to sit down in the car, that she was steady. So you put this down in that little U-shaped thing, and this sticks out, and she could reach and get a hold of it, and that was good and tight to help her turn around and sit down into the car. Then you just pull it out, put it in the side pocket of your door, your glove box, or somewhere. Don't leave it loose in your car. You guys know you're not supposed to leave stuff like that loose in your car, so if you have an accident, it's going to fly around, bonk you on the top of the head, and that's not going to be good. So it's super neat. This has all kinds of emergency things on it. Like right here is a little razor blade in case you need to cut your Cheetos open, I guess. See the little razor blade? I don't know why we need a razor blade in emergency, but there it is. And this end is, no, this is the truth. This end is for you to crack your windshield or your glass if you were to get stuck in your car and had to get out. Oh, Lord have mercy. What's going to happen to put us in that situation? You know, I guess the car goes out in the ocean, and I've watched too much NCIS. I don't know, but I'm just glad that it's a nice cane. It's to cut the seatbelt. That's right, Beth. Beth Crosby just wrote it's to cut the seatbelt. Good point. Thank you, my dear. You need one of these. It's going to be a wonderful investment of $12 in your life, and you have that extra safety for when you're traveling with your loved one. Amazon.com, but don't do it that way. Go to smile.amazon.com, and there will be a little drop down menu, and you choose Senior Life Journeys. That's our registered name with the government. We love those people. And when you do that, every time you buy off Amazon, they will make a donation to us based on how much you spent. It don't cost you a dime. And they just send us a little check, and it's wonderful. We use it to support our ministry. Speaking of which, we thank you for supporting us. You can go to letstalkdementia.org and make a donation there securely online, or you can mail a donation if you prefer, and you can write me and I can send you that mailing address. I don't put my mailing address on my website for safety reasons, but you can email me carol@letstalkdementia.org and I can share that with you. Okay, what else do I want to tell you today about traveling? Let me see. I think we've got it covered right now. I am looking forward to finding out that Michael's car is only needing a battery, and they got it fixed, and he'll spend another night and eat at the Waffle House a few more meals. Oh, joy for that. And get himself back home. You know, God is good. He takes care of us. And when I got in touch with that tow truck driver, he's like, ma'am, I don't know where he is, but I'm going to go find him. And I said, well, he's on 301 somewhere, and I don't know which direction he's heading, but he said, don't worry, I'm going to go find him. Bye. I'm like, okay. He didn't ask for money or anything. And in about 20, 25 minutes, Michael called and said, tow truck guy's here, and we're in his car, his truck, and it's cool, and we're thankful. Yay, God is good. How often is God good, y'all? Anybody know? Quick, write it in. How often is God good? Huh? The answer is all the time. Y'all don't forget that. Take care of your LOs today. Order you one of these little doodaddies. While you're there, order you a copy of Reminisce and Worship, or Let's Talk Dementia, or Mama is Confused and So Am I, or what's the other one? If My Body's a Temple, Why Am I Eating Donuts? Should say, Why Am I Eating Cheetos? Because that's what we talked about today. You guys have a great day. Be sure and check out our sponsors, Life in the Carolinas at lifeinthecarolinas.com, HD Imports, 803-985-0985, and Editor Beth at editorbeth.com. You guys have a great day. Bye. See you tomorrow.